481's a beautiful day. It's just about 5 o'clock. I'm going to head into town, meet the grandparents for dinner since I'm not going to be going over to their house tomorrow on Saturday. And check this out. This is like day 7 or something crazy of just perfect weather. Yeah, I got up about 11 o'clock today. Met my grandmother for lunch in Kent. That was very nice at Puffer Belly's. Took some photos. Maybe I'll throw those in there. But I mowed over there, got my money, so I mowed over, actually not yet, I have to go over tonight. And mowed over there and got paid for the month of April, so that's good. And I'm about halfway. I'm just going to wait until I have the lawn mowing money and stuff and cash set aside to upgrade the display and the computer in here. And I'm about halfway to the point of the display, so that's good news. Then a couple weeks, then I'll be able to order that. Not in much of a hurry, but we'll get that done. So it's a great day, it's classy as hell today. And I'm gonna go have a good dinner.
We got a nice VW.
There's the E60 M5, previous owner of this M5. If I weren't going over to dinner, I'd stop and go find him. But I do not have time for that. Kenan's over at Land of Make Believe, and there's nowhere to park, and I'd like to be there a couple minutes early to get a good table. So I don't see him, I didn't see Kenan, I guess they're inside, but maybe we'll hang out tonight. And I know, it's a V8, it's an Audi 4.4, I think. It's a good car.
Check it out, we got a Bentley friggin' GT up here, and there's Lake Erie, and the Key Building's back there. Yeah, Bentley. Guy's wearing Armani or Gucci's or something. Friggin' rights he is. Oh, friggin' rights, he just gave it big time. He's all the way down there. Too bad the Camry's in the way.
There she be. And that's Terminal Tower. Look, Kenan, Pinkerton.
Well, it is just a beautiful night.
Beautiful night to get out. It's 50 degrees now at 8 o'clock. Should be back in Hudson by about 8:20 at 74 miles an hour. And see if we can find any more nice cars out. I just passed a Audi S7, which is, I think, the first one I've seen. There's the M5 again. There's Dave's E60. Why is he everywhere out today? I have seen so many BMW M's. There's a Vette behind me. It's down to 46 degrees here at 8:15. Just back in town, I'm on 91 South, coming into the quaint, affluent town of Hudson. And I should have made a right on Middleton there. But anyways, it's a great night. It's a really nice night to get out. The S7, I saw one in Detroit. Actually, it could have been Cleveland. One of the auto shows had an S7. It's very nice. Absolutely love it. However, I don't know if I told you guys, the third most beautiful thing I have ever seen, as I have concluded this week, is the BMW F12 GT. The 640 right now. They're not making a 650 or M6 yet at this point. Grand Coupe. Wow. Third most beautiful thing I've ever seen, hands down, 6GT. Beautiful. Beautiful job, BMW. Hey, what's up, guys? It's 11:44. I'm just out here in, actually, the garage, talking to Bobby and Kenan, cleaning my wheels, cleaning my exhaust. I'd say it's really nice out here, but it's like 39 degrees, except I'm not cold. Just cleaned out my exhaust again, because that's what I do on Friday nights. We got paper towels and WD-40, got some nice clean wheels, and that's what I love about having a perfectly clean, washed and waxed car, is it's really easy to come out with the towel. And after a week of driving and, you know, maybe 200 miles, get it right back to that perfect state again. Just a little bit of dust builds up on the paint and whatever. And now it's like I just washed it again, with the exception of some bugs up here probably, coming back from Cleveland. Anyways though, it was a really good day. Had a great dinner. Just really chill. Kenan was busy tonight, so we didn't do the usual Friday night shenanigans in the basement and donuts and stuff, but that's all right. Got up at noon, 11 something like I said earlier. Just a really chill day.
And this is probably about the third time the MacBook Pro has actually been out here in the garage. I don't like having it sit out here. We got bugs and stuff. You know, I painted most of this wall and it actually turned out really well. I only went up about this high. I can almost reach the ceiling. These are 9-foot ceilings. And I definitely could have gotten up there, but check that out. You can't even see where I stopped painting, which would have been somewhere in here, and there's no clear line over there too. But
my dad's coming over tomorrow, as I think I mentioned before. He's gonna bring the X5 over, and we're gonna get these Pirellis put on over in Streetsboro. I think
They open at 8, and they said that
Saturdays get really busy, so we're going to try to get over there just before 8 o'clock. I think he's going to come here maybe around 7:30. So then we'll get over there, have him put the Pirellis on, come back. He wants to kind of redo some of his, not redo, but, you know, really clean up his wheels. It's a really nice car. I love it. He likes it. And he's been driving it 100 miles a day to work and back, and the wheels have just gotten, you know, dirty, and there were old wheel weights.
Like, his wheel pattern's nowhere near as dense as mine. And in here, you know, they put the wheel weights on there for balancing.
And when they took the old ones off to put the new ones on, at some point when he had tires rebalanced or whatever, there's all this gunk in there, and it just gets stuff, and it's disgusting. You can see it because it's not a dense pattern at all. So we're going to clean that, and there's a couple stone chips on there. He got some BMW wheel paint for it, so we're going to rejuvenate his wheels tomorrow and get the tires on, hopefully fix my ding in this wheel that causes 20 pounds a day to leak out of it. You can see I've been using this compressor over here. But I'll definitely film some of that tomorrow. Working on the car, I like that. Saturday, car day with Dad. Somebody pointed this out to me a couple days.
Over here, there's three lights in the garage, and maybe if we can get it to focus up here.
As you can see, I've got two light bulbs in there. I have a socket that splits it out to two ways. I have 260s there and 260s there,
and that light over the M5 has never worked. We custom built this house in 1986, right? So there were originally three lights in here with one bulb apiece, and that never worked. We had the builder come back out and stuff, and the attic, I can get up there through that hole that's over there, and there is live power. Like, there's a wall that splits off here and goes up for the roof line because it comes down like that. And right up until about 2 feet to that light, there is power. So it's obviously something with that socket, which we can't get to. We can't replace it from here. We'd have to, it would be a pain in the ass to cut a hole in that wall up there and crawl over there and fix it. So it's really annoying for me now that I'm always over here on this side of the garage, you know, working on stuff over here on this side of the car. It's actually pretty dark. I can still see it to clean the wheels and whatnot. But I would love to fix that, and unfortunately I can't. I could unscrew that bulb right now and stick my tongue in there and nothing would happen because there's no power. So before I talk for another 10 minutes and waste your time, I'm going to wrap up this video. I think today was day 481. As I said before, it was just a chill day off. I needed that. I guess it's Good Friday, and it was definitely a Good Friday. Oh, by the way, I also kind of fixed that spot over here. You can see I didn't paint down all the way because the stuff was in the way and I wasn't feeling like moving it. Where last year, I started up the mower in the garage, which was dumb, and a big bubble of carbon came out of the exhaust port here and exploded all over the wall, and it was just black. So I think my dad and I are going to get more paint tomorrow. I doubt we'll do it tomorrow, but sometime in the next few weeks, I hope to repaint the entire rest of the garage. It's not bad. You know, there's a couple little marks from somebody rode their bike there and screwed that up. I'm going to have to get some spackling. And then over here, you know, you can see people slide stuff in the house that gets dicked. But we need to clean some of the spider webs out of here and then repaint it, and then we'll be good to go. So hope you guys had a good Friday, and have a great weekend, and I'll talk to you tomorrow. Good night.